Let's take a look at the Handshake Protocol. As we have discussed, the Handshake Protocol establishes a TLS session, and it negotiates the security parameters between the client and the server. The phase one of the protocol establishes the security capabilities. It is initiated by the client sending a client hello message to the server. The client hello message contains a number of parameters, including version number, session ID, crypto suite, compression method, and the initial random numbers. After sending the client hello message, the client waits for the server hello message, which contains the same kind of parameters as the client hello message. Therefore, at the end of phase one, both the client and the server know each other's security capabilities. The details of phase two depend on the underlying public key encryption scheme that is being used. In some cases, the server passes a certificate to the client and possibly some additional key information and a request for a certificate from the client. The final message has to be server hello done, which indicates the end of phase two. In phase three, the server should first verify the certificate of the server. For example, if the client is connecting to a server, say Georgia Tech's website, then the client should be able to verify that the certificate contains the Georgia Tech's public key. That is, the public key certificate is Georgia Tech's public key signed by the private key of the certificate authority, and the client has the private key of the certificate authority to verify the certificate. Then the client can send key exchange information to the server. For example, the client can generate a secret key and encrypt the secret key using the server's public key and send it to the server. Depending on the application requirements, the client may send a certificate to the server in order to authenticate the client to the server. Usually, if a website is public-facing, then the authentication is typically one way. That is, the client needs to authenticate the server, but the server does not require the client to authenticate itself. On the other hand, for internal or private web servers, mutual authentication may be required. In phase two, the client sends a change cipher spec message and copies the pending security parameters to the current cipher spec. It then signals the completion of the Handshake Protocol. In response, the server sends its own change cipher spec. Therefore, they now agree on the security parameters, and then the server sends its own message to signal the end of Handshake. At this point, the Handshake is complete, and the client and server can begin to exchange application layer data protected using the agreed-upon security parameters.